So, what do you think that number is? Well, that number is a good estimate of the number of organisms that are in the oceans. 28 zeros. It's a large number, and a significant number of organisms that are in that number are microbes. Microbes are universally dominant. They control the environment that they live in, and ultimately they actually control the environment we live in as well. I was very excited to see a video come out called One Strange Rock, and in that video we were able to get a better idea of one group of organisms we're interested in, and those are the diatoms.
Looking at the oceans from space, sometimes you see a local area that's an entirely different color. Amazingly enough, what you're looking at is microscopic life. Diatom blooms that reflect the light differently so that they show up from space.
Biggest one I think I ever saw was huge. It covered hundreds of miles.
You know, when you swim in the ocean, you don't notice the diatoms around you. But when you're in space, you see the vibrant colors of life.
It's just so stunning, the blues and the greens, but also like, wow, those things are keeping us alive.
So, diatoms are not only important in oxygen production, but they're very abundant. There's thousands, hundreds of thousands of species that can be found everywhere in every kinds of water quality. And that's one of the things we're interested in. The other thing we're interested in is trying to understand the history. When you look at the fossils, the fossil shells from these diatoms, we can look back into the past. For example, the 60 million year old sample contains billions, if not trillions, of diatoms. And so this gives us a chance to look at past environments. So the two major pieces of equipment we're using is the light microscope and the electron microscope. In the case of the light microscope, we have the advantage of being able to isolate specimens like the one here. If you want to see the real details, let's take a look using the electron microscope.
Un microscope électronique à balayage, MEB, utilise un faisceau d'électrons accéléré comme source d'illumination. Il permet aux chercheurs du musée de grossir un spécimen jusqu'à 350 000 fois, révélant des détails spectaculaires. Parce qu'elles vivent dans une coque de silice, les diatomées sont presque transparentes. Le MEB est un microscope à réflexion, ce qui nous permet donc de voir et d'étudier les parois de ces structures de silice et déterminer comment ces formes de vie respirent, se déplacent et se reproduisent. Le MEB est notre principal outil pour décrire et identifier les espèces de diatomées.
So diatoms are amazing. Not only do they produce oxygen for the global environment, they also produce energy, which is critical for us. They also are great indicators of water quality, which is what I am really interested in. And finally, as my colleague once said, if you can read, thank your teachers. If you can breathe, thank the diatoms.